What's up, world? Yeah, you know it's your boy again, Raymond Tackler Forever. You know what I'm saying? I just want to come through and put a little bug in the in all these promoters' ears. You know what I'm saying? Really, in particular, one specific promoter, but you know, I ain't gonna say no names. I ain't taking no slap shots at nobody, so I'm just gonna keep it G. You heard me? You know, a certain promoter in my city, man, did a birthday bash last May. And he started advertising for the show the beginning of April this year, you know, and didn't release the tickets until May 1st. So he gave everybody 29 days to get these tickets, you heard me? He gave everybody 29 days to get the tickets to the concert, you know what I mean? And I was gonna make a big deal about it, make a fuss about it and all that deal, but you know what I'm saying? Say, man, let that ride, give him a second chance. So boom, you know, months go by, time goes on. Here we go, coming up the Classic Weekend. You know, the same promoter put the flyers on Instagram, you know what I'm saying, when it was, I say October 1st, they've been floating around Instagram, all these flyers for Classic Weekend and all this whatnot. So I'm like, damn, you advertise all these flyers for Classic Weekend, but you ain't releasing the tickets till Halloween. You know, I'm like, damn, okay, now it's time for me to say something. You know, I'm like, damn, okay, don't you think people got bills to pay? You release the tickets on the 31st of Halloween. What's after the 31st? Come the 1st of November. So people got 19 days to run around crazy to find these tickets to these concerts and pay their bills and everything else. You know, I just want to say to all the promoters, man, and that worldwide, you know what I'm saying? It's more than dope boys and robbers and people that's involved in street criminal activities that come to these concerts. Keep that in your mind when you book these shows, man. Imagine how many fans these artists has that don't sell drugs, that don't rob, that out here breaking the people's houses and all this other criminal activity. You know what I mean? There's people out here that work a 9-to-5 too. That's fans of these artists. We also the ones that go to the stores and buy their music and promote them through YouTube by viewing their videos and playing their music on YouTube while y'all burning and all that nonsense. You know what I mean? We the one going to the store spending that check. You know what I mean? So think about that when y'all book these shows and everything. Think about how many people in your city that want to come to them shows that work a 9-to-5, that got bills to pay. You know what I mean? I ain't wanting to go out here go rob somebody, get the money I need. You know, I'm going to these folks' jobs and earn their check legit way. You know, so think about that. And also, at one point in time, I'm pretty sure before you came a shot caught, a big time promoter and everything, that you was a nobody too, working job to job or whatever you were doing to make money before you came a big name promoter. Think about that, man. You know, these robbers have more fans and they do the music for more than just the dope boys and the robbers and the killers in the streets and all that nonsense, et cetera, et cetera. So think about it. When you book a show again, man, think about all the people out here that working 9-to-5. Think about the ones out here that going to work every day and working their butt off, you know, while y'all out here playing. You know what I'm saying? Because that could have been more shows you could have sold right there, but y'all ain't thinking like that. You know, I said something about on this particular promoter Instagram page. You know, I said something about on this particular promoter Instagram page, but some females stuck up, you know, he couldn't respond, but you know, that's how it is, you know, when people feel they do some flawed thing, they do some flawed thing, you heard me?